4th of July week is one of the most popular times for folks to get out on the water, whether it's the Salt River or a local lake. And a lot of people may not realize it, but the time we spend out there can have a big impact on our waterways. I spent some time out by Tempe Town Lake with our green gal for some tips on keeping our water clean. According to the Environmental Working Group, Phoenix, Arizona was ranked 53 out of 100 when it comes to our water quality. And our drinking water here is a combination of both surface water and groundwater. So Titian Dockersley, our green gal, is here with me this morning. Good morning. To let us know what we all need to know about keeping our water quality good.
Let's start with like what we should not put down the drain, and then we'll get into those tubers that are probably out there right now enjoying the Salt River.
No kidding. All right. So oils and greases, I know you're not supposed to put that down the drain.
It's one of the worst things to do, and the reason is that it coagulates, you know, in our sewer, and so it could back it up and cause more problems for the treatment plant center. So the best thing to do is to put them in maybe a tightly sealed can. Just don't put them down the drain. I know maybe those greasy hamburgers are great, but hold the grease.
All right, sounds good. When it comes to prescription drugs, seems like common sense you shouldn't put that down a drain or something like that. We don't want that obviously in our water supply.
We don't, because actually some of the prescription drugs might have endocrine disruptors, so that can affect, and it may not pass through the treatment plants. It will pass through the treatment plants, so we definitely don't want to flush it or put it down the drain.
When you say endocrine disruptors, you mean our systems?
Our system. It'll actually affect our bodies, because again, if it doesn't get filtrated through the treatment plants, it can end up in our drinking water and again have more toxins for the water supply.
Okay. 4th of July is coming up. Fireworks, how does that get into our water supply?
Well, you know, people are just excited. They travel to up north. They might come to the beach park here and light off some fireworks. Well, we're encouraging not to have it near a water source. Again, you have the flames and everything. And then people sometimes leave it there.
Oh,
we don't want to do that. So
clean up your mess.
Yes.
Pool chemicals, those can't be good for our water supply.
Well, hopefully we're going to be in the pool later today. But what I suggest is if you have extra pool supplies, give it to a local community pool, maybe to a neighbor. But just don't put it down the drain, or just don't put it, you know, throw it away like that, because it will add to that.
Okay. And finally?
Okay, fish don't drink beer. I didn't know that. I didn't know if you knew that, but you know, a lot of people, again, near the water source, do not dump any of these liquids down, you know, in the water supply. It does affect the quality of the habitat. It does affect the fish and everything. Again, more contamination to our wildlife.
So we're not talking about people at home deciding to pour their beer down the drain. We're talking more about the tubers on the Salt River, folks up boating Roosevelt, maybe.
And stuff. Okay. But then, you know, consider the one. Don't put your trash, you know, obviously in the supplies. And actually, I saw some up here, so we want to pick up that trash.
Perfect. Good tips. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
All right, you can find out more information on living a green lifestyle by checking out Green Living Magazine. end up getting washed out into the ocean and end up in something like that. It's known as the Pacific Garbage Patch. It's basically a collection of trash twice the size of Texas. I spent some time out at Tempe Town Lake with our green gal who has advice on what we should and shouldn't bring to the beach. When it comes to our summer heat, this is about the time of year when half of the state gets out of Dodge and heads somewhere cooler, like the beach. Tish and Donkersley, our green gal, here with us this morning.
Thank you.
To talk about those healthy habits, those green habits that you should take with you when you head to the beach.
Absolutely. Well, the number one thing is don't take plastic bags. Plastic bags are probably the biggest culprit and the debris that we're finding out into the oceans as well. And animal life doesn't know the difference between a plastic bag and a plastic particle. So they're starting to eat that. So we're gonna start here with what not to take.
So don't take that to the beach. If you don't have to use them at all, I was kicking myself on a recent vacation because I didn't bring my reusable bags from home, and I found myself having to use the plastic bags the whole vacation.
Exactly. Well, I mean, you have to, but just know, keep the camper's motto is pack out what you pack in.
Yeah, okay.
So take it out with you, but if you can, use the reusables and other things.
Okay, that probably goes for everything you bring to the beach.
It goes everything with that, and also with the, I just want to address the plastic again. Some of these toys are left on the beach. They will eventually get swept out into the ocean, or if they break off, or just put them in the proper receptacles or take them home if you can, because again, it will affect the ocean life.
And whether it's Ziploc bags or these plastic bags or anything plastic, a lot of that can leach into the water supply then.
It can, and some of them, the plastics have the BPA, and they're not safe, so we definitely want to remove any toxins or chemicals. As I've learned is that 100,000 marine animals die every year from ingesting plastics.
All right, and then don't take glass.
Let's not take glass, obviously, and then we want to use some reusable materials that, or if you're going to use a reusable, like you said, let's use biodegradable and compostable. But again, with the plastic water bottles, again, one of the biggest problems for marine debris is plastic, so remove that if you see it. Maybe take part in a beach cleanup. That might be a great idea to participate and lower your impact as well.
Yeah, get your family involved in that. All right, things we don't often think about since we live here in the desert,
exactly.
But good things to keep in mind since almost all of us head to the beach this time of year. Thanks so much.
You betcha.
And as always, you can find more tips on living a green lifestyle by checking out Green Living Magazine. Javier and Kaylee.
All right. Good
Thank
information.
You.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. All right. We want to turn now to Mix 96.9's Matthew Blades. I know we're going to talk about Katie and Tom, but did you like Magic Mike? I thought about you Friday night.
I loved
it. You did.
Whoa. Breaking news.
Hold on a second, Javier. It was so entertaining, and it is so, I mean, yes, obviously there is the male stripping that is a part of it, but I mean,